Glare is an unavoidable characteristic of camera lenses when a bright light source is in or near the field of view. Glare reduces contrast in a scene due to Fresnel reflections at the lens surface. Notice how the contrast is improved when the light source is blocked. In this video, we show a setup in which glare can be removed in several situations using a single shot capture. We do not need to take multiple exposure images. We can remove or accentuate ghosts and flare. We can handle effects due to dust or water droplets on the lens as well. Glare can be decomposed into two main components: reflections between surfaces of lens elements, and scattering due to diffusion by the lens elements. Glare is often considered to be a low-frequency phenomenon in two dimensions. However, the ghosts and flare due to reflections inside the lens are high-frequency phenomena in four-dimensional ray space. Our setup exploits this characteristic to separate and remove these artifacts. Creating a camera that converts glare into a high-frequency 2D pattern is easy. It costs only $5 to print a pinhole mask, which we place on top of the protective glass covering of the sensor. In this work, we present results obtained with pinholes arranged in both regular and random patterns. The pinholes separate rays by angle, revealing that reflection glare that is low frequency in 2D is in fact high frequency noise in 4D. The high frequency reflection glare can then be removed by various methods, from simple outlier rejection in 2D to more sophisticated clustering in 4D. The epipolar plane image on the right was constructed from a horizontal row in the scene on the left. The reflection glare artifacts form a tube in the epipolar plane image that has a different slope compared to the in-focus scene elements. Here, reflection glare has reduced the contrast in this image. Reducing the glare improves the contrast of the strong shadows relative to the lit portions of the scene. Here, reflections inside the camera body generate stray light at angles from outside the aperture. By discarding such spurious rays, we restore contrast. In this photo, a droplet on the lens has redirected rays such that values from some color squares intrude on nearby squares. Though not generated by a bright light, this phenomenon is high frequency in 4D. Through analysis in 4D, we can manipulate the reflections occurring inside the lens in various ways. Beyond simply increasing or decreasing the contribution due to glare, we can synthesize novel views. Our method improves contrast without significant loss of resolution. We believe this to be the first single-shot optical mechanism for glare reduction after the photo has been captured. It works with minimal changes to the camera, is portable, and gives improvement in many practically challenging scenarios. Glare-producing scenes inherently span a large dynamic range. Even with unavoidable saturation, our method works in a single shot without a need for multi-exposure capture. This system demonstrates how statistical properties of 4D ray space distortion inside a camera can be exploited for novel applications without explicitly recovering a 4D light field.